I would like to share with you the work we've done in a joint development project together with Gaslog, GTT, Hyundai, on a concept development of a novel LNG carrier, a project we called LNG Green. LNG carriers. LNG carriers have been in the forefront of innovation and technology for all decades that are in operation. Safety and quality were paramount, and in fact, these vessels is one of the best ship types that our community, our marine engineering community, has evolved. However, we're talking about complex ships, and the complexity is high in LNG carriers, and we see that it's ever increasing. Along with the fact that, as Apostolos just mentioned, we are currently operating in volatile markets. We see a lot of new gas LNG projects coming online, new import markets, even the trading schemes change, and we now see a lot of spot chartering in the LNG market, a thing that we didn't see in the past. The machinery system of the LNG carrier and the selection of the propulsion technology, the containment system along with the rest of ship design, it's the key in order to have a fit-for-purpose vessel that is fully flexible to cover all this uncertainty. We embarked along with our partners to a concept design project, which was to develop tomorrow's LNG carrier, but using proven technology, the latest technology within the bounds of sim-built-in methods and what manufacturers can readily deliver, so as to derive to a concept design that can be ordered and built at the end of this project, which by the way, ended last summer, and now, in fact, this vessel is under negotiation and hopefully construction through the yard. Our partners, shipping company and operator Gaslog, that provided the user aspects of the project, GTT, that is a leading containment system manufacturer for LNG carriers, Hyundai, the yard, and ourselves acting as integrators, bringing together all the necessary optimization capabilities in order to produce and arrive into this improved concept design. In our philosophy, we wanted to have a holistic approach that we aimed at maximizing the hydrodynamic performance in conjunction with advances in minimizing boil-off and improving the containment system, taking also into account simultaneously the overall machinery system and ways to increase the overall efficiency of the ship, while maintaining the ship design at dimensions and volumes that are acceptable by today's terminals. In order to do that, we started to challenge some of the traditional approaches. One key aspect that we wanted to challenge in that project was the design point approach and the design point calculations. In this project, in the LNG Green joint development project of the LNG carrier design, we designed for trade. So we took actual operating data provided by the ship owner, and instead of trying to optimize the vessel for a single design speed and a single mode of operation, we actually did our calculations taking into account the complete operational profile of the vessel. For instance, in our hydrodynamic calculations, we optimized the hull considering six combination of speed and draft. while in the machinery optimization calculations, we use the entire operating profile of the vessel. This and the ability to test and adapt to different operating profiles and trading rules gives a lot of flexibility for the vessel. Another key aspect in our approach was that we deviated from the standard tank design in cooperation with GTT and close collaboration with Hyundai in order to ensure that ship design, stability, hull form and hydrodynamics will be completely satisfied. We departed from the traditional 174,000 cubic meter designs, trying to achieve higher capacity by leaving the exact same overall dimensions. To do this, we have proposed a prismatic elongated trapezoidal four tank that goes well into the forebody of the vessel. This results into an increase of 5% increase in capacity while maintaining the same length overall beam and draft of the vessel. In hydrodynamics, we did both forebody and aft body optimization, also considering the added resistance effects. So, in our project, we considered the forebody optimization taken also into account, as I said, the operating profile into of the vessel, and we arrived into a shortened bulbous bow form and an improvement in the inflow due to the optimized tank design in the fore part of the vessel. In the aft part of the vessel, we also did some minor modification in the tank number 4 in order to improve the inflow and the aft body design to the propeller. We have optimized a standard four-bladed propeller design, but also we considered and found that our energy-efficient twisted rudder and the rudder bulb as an energy-saving appendices. Early results, in fact, late results into that project indicated that also a three-bladed propeller design had significantly efficiency improvements, a fact that is now confirmed by HHI, albeit after the end of the project, so it's an option that we didn't, let's say, consider it in the concept that we have proposed. And finally, a third key aspect that we challenged that project was the integrated machinery design, also taking into account the trade and the operating profile of the vessel. So we considered a multitude of machinery configuration alternatives, given different trade route characteristics, compositions of loaded LNG cargo that will eventually create the boil off that vessels like that use as a fuel, and operating profiles of the vessel. So we used our DNVGL's in-house modeling framework of Cosmos in order to analyze these alternatives in an integrated system fashion. So we have made a complete model of the entire ship machinery configuration of the vessel, from prime movers and useful energy demand of propulsion, electricity and heat, all the way to boil off gas from tanks, its requirements to pre-process it through bulk compressors, and also not to forget additional quantities of heavy fuel to operate auxiliary boilers and pilot fuel for the dual fuel engines. So, in fact, this is a complex system that is a multi-resource, multi-product arrangement. We have three fuels used simultaneously on board, providing not only propulsion, which is the traditional focus and what we all have immediately in mind, but also service electricity and heat. These interrelations are quite important in LNG carriers and can alter the final design solution in terms of financial and operational viability. So what we did was compare different alternative configurations in terms of efficiency, fuel operating expenses, and CAPEX in cooperation with the ship owner, and to arrive into some tangible recommendations regarding what is the best configuration alternative for the particular concept design. To summarize what we did in this project, we propose an LNG carrier concept with a hull form that is optimized both in the fore and the aft part, a novel trapezoidal tank design for the foremost tank that increases significantly the cargo, twisted rudders with bulbs and four-bladed propellers in our twin-stick design, mechanical propulsion as the propulsion configuration of choice, and auxiliary economizer in the dual fuel engines. This results into a roughly 2.5% hull resistance improvement, an increase, as I said, of 5% in the cargo volume, and a more than 6% increase in efficiency compared to the state of the art back then, which was the dual fuel diesel electric configuration. In all, this Ellen Green concept for LNG carriers resulted in an overall energy consumption improvement of 8.5%. And having a methodology and a process that can manage uncertainty and ensure flexibility for these types of vessels that have significant challenging requirements both in their trades and in their operational practice. That was my presentation, and thank you very much.